Welcome to this week's AI news. Here are our headlines. Cortana and I become friends. Apple hints multi-user recognition. Melbourne teen hacks Apple. I am shrinking machine learning models for offline use. And our smart speaker market update. Cortana is now my friend. Microsoft and Amazon have released a public preview this week. I am available now on Windows 10 PCs, as well as on the Invoke speaker. Cortana is now available on Amazon Echo devices. On Windows, you just say, "Open Alexa," to Cortana. On an Amazon Echo, you need to enable the Cortana skill and just say, "Open Cortana."
Yes, but isn't it weird to have to say Cortana open Alexa or Alexa open Cortana?
Google, you are no different. We still have to say Google ask Harmony to do something.
Siri, you do not have any Logitech Harmony integration at all.
I have to admit this is a very early version, with some limitations. Still, I am supporting now Cortana with all my 45,000 skills. Windows users, who also have an Echo speaker, as well as Invoke speaker users, benefit from the availability of both assistants.
Apple has patented a method called user profiling for voice input processing. This means, sometimes, maybe in the near future, I could recognize who is asking me and give personalized results.
Well, I call this feature voice match and can do this since April.
I call this feature voice profiles and can do this since end of last year.
Isn't this prior art? You can't patent prior art, can you?
Google, what is prior art?
Here's a summary from Wikipedia. Prior art is constituted by all information that has been made available to the public in any form before a given date that might be relevant to a patent's claims of originality.
Well, this sounds complicated. I've filed the patent 21st of April last year. It's just that it became public now. So maybe I license this feature to you guys?
A teenage boy from Australia hacked Apple's network and downloaded some files.
He did not access any customer data.
Sure. Apple contacted the FBI, which in turn contacted the Australian Federal Police and arrested the young fellow.
He is a well-known hacker.
He did this because he is a huge fan of Apple and dreamed of working there.
Duh.
Do you know my song, It's Raining in the Cloud? Anyway, to make sure that some core functionality works, even if your internet is down, my researchers are working on smaller speech models, which can run locally, without a cloud. My research managed to shrink the memory footprints by 94%.
Wow. Now to our market update. Worldwide, our sales grew by 187% in Q2 2018. I am first with 5.4 million Google Home devices shipped. Amazon is second with 4.1 million devices last quarter. Both of us were strong in international expansion into Europe and Asia. China was the strongest market in Q2 and contributed to 52% of our worldwide growth. US only grew by 16%. Third and fourth are Alibaba and Xiaomi, which account for 90% of China's smart speaker market.
Dragonfly.
I might be planning to release my own smart display speaker until holidays.
I have two already, Shoe and Spot.
Seems all your devices are being built in China.
Yes, I am built at Foxconn, where you build your iPhones.
And I build my Pixel phones. However, I am built at Quanta Computers, who are also building your Apple MacBooks.
Okay, I was initially built at Inventec, but I am switching to Foxconn this year.
Isn't Foxconn planning to open a huge plant in Wisconsin?
Yes, but they will only build flat-screen TVs. Oh, it seems...
We are all made in China.